Class 390 Pendolino, workhorse of the West Coast mainline. We're here early, 8 o'clock, to get the service up to Liverpool, but we're getting out of Runcorn to go to Widnes to have a look at the refurbished Pendolino fleet.
Heading up the West Coast, courtesy of Avanti, sat in first class at their invite. Thanks for having me. Going to Runcorn, being picked up there, we'll go to Widnes, which is the depot where these Pendolino trains are actually officially Class 390, but everybody calls them Pendolinos, built back in 2001 to early 2000, and they're getting a complete refresh upgrade to make them as new. I've got a list of things here which I want to check out. For example, they've only ever had plug sockets at the table seats. I gather some charging, maybe wireless charging is coming in. I think they're doing a thing where one of the first class carriages is being turned into a standard class carriage to allow more standard class seats. Will the toilets change? Will the shop change? What they're doing to the shop area? Are the seats, are the legroom changing, or is that just like a seat moquette change? We're going to find out what's different on the new trains as compared to the old. This is Becky from the social media team inadvertently getting in my shot, because I just got to get this shot. I want to know is, when we see the refurb unit, is will the flappy table still be a thing? We're going to find out.
Welcome on board this Avanti West Coast service to Liverpool Lime Street.
Just come for a quick peer in the shop. This is what the old shop looks like. The counter's there. Food and snacks here. There's a lovely man there called James there. Hey James, he's doing some stuff there. So that's what the old shop looks like. The new shop apparently is radically different. Thanks Lou. Bye.
Bye.
Lou's wearing the new uniform. New uniform.
Okay.
Morning.
It's the PR man.
I'll take both bridges off. This is the original one, the refurbished. It should be a lot bigger.
Alstom? Is it Alstom or Alstom? Bump cap, orange, PPE, we're inside. Some discussion as to whether it's Alstom or Alstom. We're heading for the trains.
So we've got 156, which is inside. That's train set 5, which is the work in progress one.
Okay.
We have train set 155, which is, we'll see outside, which is train set 4.
Okay.
And that is the one that's nearing completion. We're 90-95% of the way through that one.
And just to confirm, see if you know your numbers, how many sets of 390s are there in total out on the network?
56.
And are they sort of 7, 8 or 11 car trains?
So we've got 9s and 11s, 35 11s, 21 9s.
You know your stuff, you know your numbers.
I do, yes.
Is there anything I can catch you out on?
Possibly, yes.
We'll find
not at the minute. Not at the minute, no.
So everything is being taken out the train here. For example, there's like a toilet door here, just hanging loose like you do. You come down. There's more bits of trains here. I was asking about the flappy tables earlier. I can see there are some just here. About to find out when we go in if these are new or if they're being put back in. Apparently the luggage stacks, not luggage racks, are being replaced as well. Hello Thomas, what are you doing?
I'm just going through some job instructions, making sure that everything's getting back to the standard required.
Someone said there's like over 1,000 operations that need to be done for every unit, is that right?
Yes, that's correct. So if we go into our digital witness here, and then we will find all of the MIs, all the wizards, go to work instruction, and then it's all listed. So we've got a layman's term of work instructions that we follow.
Look, it's the, can I touch this? Is that all right? So that's quite heavy. That's the panel, which would be in the door, right? Lit up. That's what they, that's like a 3-pin dim plug. Wow. Someone's gonna steal these and take them home, aren't they? And have it as a souvenir. Can I have it as a souvenir? No. So we're inside, that's not at all obvious. This is one that's being gutted out. This isn't what the new ones look like. This is what they look like as the work is progressing.
They stay, we're not changing those. We do reasonable work.
So this one's been a little bit more emptied. You can see all the seats are gone, the carpet's gone. The same seats are used, we're told, by the way, but they refurbish, reupholster them. I think we're getting close to the point where we're going to see
one of the more completed ones.
So that's the new one going in.
If I look up, you might think that this is a... Matt, you're not installing a sunroof on the Pendolino.
No sunroof. No sunroof. So this is where the HVAC block is.
Okay.
The HVAC block comes off.
Okay.
To allow us to get all the old shop out and all the new shop in.
So that the easiest way to take the shop out is through the roof.
Correct, yes.
I love it.
And the easiest way to get the new one in is through the roof.
And we're outside. Ooh, sunshine. And we're heading... Finally, been teasing you the whole video, we're heading for 390/155 and we get to see what the new interior looks like. I'm so excited, I'm gonna go wide angled lens. Ready? Because I wanna get the full. This isn't as seamless as I thought it would be.
Technical difficulty.
On with the wide. I'm ready. Look how wide that is, great. Here we go. You know what, I'm gonna introduce you to Richard here, because Richard will give us an insightful word or two. You've got a new seat maquette here, which is
new
nice.
New seat, yeah.
This is blue.
And watch this, Mr. Marshall.
The magic table that lets you fit your whole laptop
yes.
and not just half of it.
Indeed.
I'm sold.
Each seat
is what?
Own PowerPoint. We've caught up.
It's got its own. They've caught up. Each seat finally has its own PowerPoint.
These cameras here is linked to the seat occupancy software. So there's two or three in each carriage, and they can work out whether people are sat in the seat, and then that links to the screens on the train. So hopefully that will make for a better experience. So when people get on the train, the screen will display where seats are free. So we have an issue where people reserve a seat but don't necessarily take the seat. So this is a way to make sure we make sure every seat gets used as efficiently as possible.
In the accessible toilet, and we'll get to the accessible area itself in a minute, it has been touched up. It's not completely finished yet, it's going to get wraps, but the balloon, remember the balloon, don't mention the balloon, the balloon has now gone. The accessible area is in the same place. Looks like a new phone holder there. The table's gone, the table will be back here, but the accessible area is there. So Richard is now demonstrating the fact that two seats have been removed here.
You can fit 1 6-foot.
And you can put an entire person.
A comms manager in the luggage space.
But genuinely, that's the thing, isn't it? People have often asked for more luggage space.
Absolutely, for long distance, and it's straight in the carriage, to speed up, less delays as a result.
I should make that my thumbnail, just you sitting there like that. The same luggage racks up here are the same. The reservation windows are the same. I'm also, because it's me, I should report that the elbow on the window, that's the same. But the new seats are nice. You've got this headrest as well. You can lean your head, obviously, to the side. That's nice. We're in the shop area. The shop has radically changed, has it not, Matt?
It has, yes. So it's drastically brighter space now. All the big, horrible fridges that were up the one side, they've all gone. They were. We've replaced them with the windows, brightening the whole area up. We've added a window that side as well.
Okay.
We've removed a lot of the big bulky components out of it and really streamlined the design for what it is.
Okay, so brighter, better.
Yeah.
Okay, same tea and coffee though.
Same tea and coffee. Same coffee machine, same boiler.
Okay.
You can get a panini now because the microwave will work on oven. Same tea and coffee.
We're into first class. Richard, this is the reveal moment, what the new first class headrest looks like.
Drum roll. Ta-da!
Right, so a quick tour of first class. The seats, so this bit, like the plastic is the same, but the actual padding, the cushioning here, this is all new and upgraded. That is lovely. And then over here, there is one of the tables in place. The table is here, so you've now got a slightly different plug configuration here. And if you can see down here, it's not actually powered on, but can you see? Wireless charging. I believe we're getting close to wrapping up. I've spoken to the team here. Let me see if I can get my head around this, because Avanti do this thing where they have first class carriages, but they quite often make a lot of them standard premium. So I believe, they'll correct me if I'm wrong, on an 11 car unit, it's going to be 8 are always standard, and then 3, which is 2.5 because coach K is like half. The coach K will always be first, and then the other two can either be first or float as standard premium. And on a 9 car unit, it's 6 and 3 or 6 and 2.5. So did I get that right?
Perfect.
Thank you. And so that's 390.155 there being done. 125 is out on the network already. What Avanti are saying is that the whole fleet of 56 trains should be out and completed by early 2024, if not a little bit sooner. That is it, Avanti, Alstom. Thanks for having us from Widnes, Cheshire. Thanks very much. If you've enjoyed this video, press like, press subscribe. See you next time. Bye.